Hey YouTube, Mushy here with another quick tutorial. This time I'll be teaching you how to set up one of the best free text-to-speech generators I can currently find. If there's a better one out there, please let me know in the comments below. I'm always trying to find new and better programs to use. Anyways, it's amazing to me how many of these out there want to charge you a bunch of money and are as good, if not worse, than this one. This one allows you to generate from huge chunks of text around 30,000 characters or more. On top of that, there's over 50,000 user-created voice models to use with it, and I'll show you how to get those added in as well. So to get started, we'll first need to install Python 3.9. Any version should work. I'm just gonna go with 3.9.13 because I know it works. I'll have all the links in the video description. So just head over, scroll to the bottom of the page, and download the recommended Windows installer, unless you're on a different platform. And go ahead and install it. Next, we'll want to head over to Applio's GitHub page, scroll down to the installation section, and click on GitHub releases. And we're going to want to download the compiled version. Just click on that. And I've already downloaded it, so just pause the video if you need to catch up. So once you got the zip file downloaded, just cut it, paste it where you want to install it. I'm going to paste it in my AI folder and extract it right there. So this is going to be the fastest way to install this. If this doesn't work, there is another method, which will take 2 to 3 times as long, but it should solve any issue you might have. So you're going to want to head back to this page and download the source code zip file. And we would basically do the same thing, cut the zip file, paste it where we want to install it, and we would extract it right here. So in this extracted folder, you're gonna see run-install.bat, and that's what you want to launch. And that'll just start automatically installing everything. It should solve any issues you might have if it didn't work the first time. But I'm not gonna use that, so I'm just gonna delete it here. And now that that's done extracting, I'm just gonna rename this to Applio, keep it simple, so my desktop shortcuts will always work. Just open the folder and execute the run-applio.bat and fire it up. And it should just work. It'll look something like this. So the main thing we're going to be using is this text-to-speech tab. So click into here, and here's all the voices. These are the base voices you'll start with. There's so many different languages also. So I'm just gonna select English, US, Christopher. Get some example text from Marcus Aurelius. And down here you had some advanced options. So basically how this is gonna work is it'll generate this text off of this base voice, and then that'll create an output file. and then you'll have the voice model, so the 50,000 different voice models you can choose from. The voice model will generate off at the base TTS voices. So any emotion or cadence or inflections will translate from the base voice onto the voice model. And that's especially important if you're gonna use like a girl voice model, then you need to have a girl bass model, or else it'll sound weird, unless you want to do something like that. Maybe that's what you're going for. It sounds pretty crazy. All right, so to get the custom voice models, we're gonna want to head over to voice-models.com. I'm just gonna go to top models, and I'm gonna select this e-girl uwu model for the example. Just click on that. Just extract that. You can save the zip file if you plan on building up a repository. But basically what's going to happen . We're going to want to go into the download tab, and you'll see we have a path file and an index file. We want to drag the path file in first, and it'll copy it in. Then we want to drag the index file second, in that order. And basically what that does is it copies the two files over into the logs folder, and it's created a folder for it called eGirlT. It just copies the files in there, so you can basically just delete these if you want in your downloads folder. Go back to the TTS tab, hit refresh. Now we got the custom voice. Make sure you match the index file up properly with the path file. And so these advanced settings here, I wouldn't really mess with too much unless you know what you're doing. The main thing is the pitch, and the pitch is only going to affect the voice model. So when it outputs these two different files, I believe these advanced settings will only affect the RVC file. So I'll just quickly run that. And then they have different algorithms which you can use. I'm just going to use the default because it's good. You probably won't really need to mess with this much. And it's already done. So once it's done, the default folder it had it set up as is in the assets audios folder. Show you what it sounds like. So this is the bass voice. And I had it set to a male voice, so it's probably
Marcus Aurelius Red. The mind adapts and converts to its own purposes.
But because I used a female voice model, it's probably going to sound really weird.
Marcus Aurelius Red, the mind adapts and converts to its own purposes the obstacle to...
So, we probably don't want that. Maybe you do want that. I'm going to change it, the base model, to a girl. And it should be good. I'll re-render it. It's done.
Marcus Aurelius Red, the mind adapts and converts to its own purposes the obstacle to our acting. the impediment to action advances action. What stands in the way becomes the way. It is from his Meditations, Book 5.20.
Sounds way better. One of my favorite quotes from Marcus Aurelius. And I'll just quickly show you one more thing. The amount of text this can generate at a time is ridiculous. It's almost 32,000 characters right there. And it's actually letting me do it, so that's crazy. So it just finished. I think it took about 2 minutes to do that. And I'm using a 3080 Ti, but it does use this quite a bit of CPU, so I'm not sure if it's more GPU dependent or CPU dependent. But it allowed me to do that, and it generated a file.
From my grandfather Verus, I learned good morals.
A 37-minute file, over 30,000 characters of text, that's absolutely insane. And it only took 2 minutes. Unbelievable. Like, I love this. I'm going to be using this for a while. Unless, of course, somebody can find something better. There's always new stuff coming out. But I think that's about it. I hope that helps you guys out. Leave me a like or maybe subscribe, and catch you later. Peace.